everyone, it's great to have you tuned in to the third episode of Showcase with the beauty expert Kanchan Varraj. If you're new to my channel and have not watched the last two episodes in this series with her, I will leave those links in the description box down below as always and on the screen for you guys as well. These videos are both informative as well as educative, so please do go ahead and watch them as well. Now, on to today's video, Kanchan will be taking us through two different eye looks in detail, transitioning from daytime into nighttime. And she will be demonstrating these looks on a special guest that we have with us today here, and her name is Smriti Mannar. Hi Smriti, welcome. Are you excited to be here?
Hi, I'm super excited to be here. I want to thank the both of you for choosing me, and I can't wait to get started.
So glad. Kanchan, are you ready to give her a makeover?
Yes, I'm ready to.
So if you always struggle with eye looks and want to master this, jump on it and let's get rolling.
So the first thing that I'm going to use is the eye cream, which is by Kiehl's, the creamy eye treatment with avocado. This is a very important step, keeping in mind the hydration we need for the eyes. Can you look up? Can you look up to the camera? Now I'm going to take my ring finger and very softly press it into the skin. Look here. You can either pat it into the skin like this, or you can just gently massage it. The next important step would be to use an eyeshadow base. My favorite would be the Soft Ochre Paint Pot from MAC. This goes with almost all Indian skin tones. So for people who are fair to medium skin, and for people who are more dusky, I would prefer Groundwork. Use this on the entire lid space up to the arch below the eyebrow. This is going to help in getting the perfect color payoff when we use eyeshadows on top, and it's also going to prevent the eyeshadows from creasing. It's also very important to use some amount of the eyeshadow base just below their waterline, just to make sure that the eyeshadows that you use below to smoke doesn't bleed over and it lasts all day. Now I'm going to take a small eyeshadow brush, and I'm going to take the shade Bare from the Huda Beauty Nude Palette. And I'm just going to gently tap it just below her eyebrow to highlight the bone here. Now I'm taking the shade Sandalwood from the Huda Beauty Rose Gold Remastered Palette. And I'm just going to use a blending brush, and I'm just going to softly blend it into her brow bone area. So I'm just using soft circular motions to do the blending. What I'm doing is just taking product bit by bit and building until I'm happy. Now I'm taking the shade Henna from the same palette, and I'm just using it lower than the previous shade in the same circular motion. Now I'm going to take the shade Dip Down. It's like a gel based product from MAC, and it's a dark brown. So I'm just going to take a little bit in a small brush. And I'm just gonna use a tiny amount on her lid. And I'm gonna immediately blend it before it dries. You can even use a brown pencil for this. You needn't really use the same gel based product. If a pencil works and if it's easier to blend for you, then you can just use that instead of this. If you're going to use a gel based product, just be very quick to blend it, because if it dries then it's going to become patchy. Now I'm going to pick up the brown shade from the Huda Beauty Rose Gold palette, and it's called Coco. So you pick it up with the same blending brush and just softly blend it across the gel based liner that you did. Just make it very soft and let your strokes be very gentle. Now I'm going to pick up the shade Henna again from the same palette, and I'm just going to go onto the lid space that doesn't have the dark brown, just so that it looks nice and soft and blended. So now I'm going to use the MAC Black Track gel liner to give a nice thin winged liner. Now I'm going to use the Shiseido eye curler. I'm just going to curl the lashes. Open eyes. I'm going to be using the Benefit Bad Girl Bang Mascara for the eyelashes. This is a very nice mascara to use, especially on a daily basis, especially if you're not looking for waterproof mascaras, because using waterproof mascaras on a daily basis can lead to lash loss. This is smudge proof and it should work for a day-to-day usage. I'm going to be using the lashes by Girl Lash, and I'm going to be using the Huda Beauty Lash Adhesive to stick these lashes. I really like these lashes because they are 3D mink lashes and it looks really feathery and nice and natural once it's on. At the same time, it adds enough glamour to the entire look. Now I'm going to be using the Goof Proof Brow Pencil by Benefit in number 4 to fill her eyebrows. I'm going to start with the arch of her eyebrows, where I want the maximum intensity. She has a pretty good brow shape, so I'm just going to fill in where she needs it the most. The stroke should be in the direction of her hair growth. Important step is to take the spoolie brush and just blend it and groom the eyebrows. I'm going to take the same dark brown shade called Coco from the Huda Beauty Remastered palette, and I'm just gonna look at these. Just softly use this below her lash line. Now I'm gonna take the same mascara, the Benefit Bad Girl Bang mascara. I'm just gonna gently use it on the lower lash line. This is the step most of us forget, but it's very important. I'm not going to be using Kohl on the lower lash line because I want to keep it very casual. So this is the final finished look of a casual matte smoky eye, perfect for the day or for any other casual event. So now let's see how we can use 2-3 quick simple steps and transition this into a glamorous night look. I'm going to take the Huda Beauty Coral Obsessions palette, and I'm going to select this nice coppery, peachy, shimmery eyeshadow with a flat eyeshadow brush, and I'm just gonna press and slide this color all over her lid. It's very important that you press and slide the brush so that the product glides on smoothly. Notice that I'm going to be using this product only to the 3/4 of the eyelid, and I'm just going to leave the corner empty. Now I'm going to take the shade Bubbly from the Huda Beauty Rose Gold Remastered Palette, and I'm just going to lay it on the inner corners of her eye. I'm going to be taking the Black Truffle eyeshadow from the same palette, and I'm just going to etch this on the outer corners of her eye in the form of a V. So it gives a nice smoky effect. Again, be careful so that you don't drag the product into the eyelids. Just retain it on the outer corner of the eye. Now, I'm going to take the shade Coco from the same palette, which is a dark brown, and I'm just going to transition the edges of the black. So it looks nice and soft. Take the same eyeshadow and softly blend the outer corner of the black as well, so it doesn't look too stark. I'm going to take the same shade Bubbly that we used on the inner corners and just highlight under the arch of her eyebrows. Now it's time for my favorite step, where we add in some glamour with glitter. So I'm going to be using the Makeup Forever Diamond Dust in number 2. So the way we use it is going to be very simple. We're going to use the MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus Spray from a distance on the eyelids. We're going to pick up the glitter with our ring finger and just tap it on the areas where we've used the frosty colors. And look how pretty it looks. As we do this, we can notice that the liner has just faded with all the eyeshadows. So let's just restore this liner using the Inglot number 77 gel liner. Now it's time to clean the lashes with some mascara. Can we see all these fallouts from the eyeshadows? So you can just use the mascara wand over the fallouts to just give it a cleaner look. Or you can simply replace the lashes, whatever works for you. Now I'm using the same gel liner on the lower lash line with a small angled brush. I'm going to use this small tiny pencil brush and just smoke out the lower lash line. So this is how we used 2 to 3 simple easy steps to transition the daytime simple look to a glamorous night look.
So Suri, did you enjoy being part of this shoot?
I loved it. It was so easy and you guys are so great. Thank you so much again. I love it, oh my god, I'm not getting over this. I don't even want to take it.
Thank you so much for teaching us how to transition from, you know, day to night with such easy steps, right? That's what makes this such a beautiful transition.
I'm so glad and I really hope everyone likes it too.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I hope you all enjoyed this little tips and tricks from this video, and you can use this for this upcoming festive season. And as always, it means a lot if you could like this video, share it with your family and friends, and subscribe if you still haven't to my channel. Until next time, stay happy, stay healthy, and stay blessed. Bye-bye.